Senior Martin Park is a graduate of the Music Institute of Chicago and will be continuing his education at the Jacobs School of Music at Indiana University, who is now happy to perform on the organ here at Rockefeller Chapel, playing the prelude for today's commencement ceremonies.
Thank you.
Mount Carmel. On behalf of Mr. John Stimler, our principal, and the faculty and administration, I am to welcome you to the 113th Annual Commencement Ceremony at Mount Carmel High School. As we gather today in this beautiful chapel, we turn our hearts and minds to God who has given us life, and whose Spirit sustains us each of our days. Together, celebrate the hard work and achievement of our graduates. We give thanks for the support and love of their parents and grandparents and families, and an appreciation of dedication and leadership of our faculty and staff. To celebrate our alumni today is Father Tony Mazurkiewicz, president of Mount Carmel High School. The homilist will be Father Benjamin Aguilar. He'll be joined by your fellow Carmelites, Father Peter Ramirez, Father Marlon Mateo, Father Enrique Barrera, Brother Matthew Gomez. Please stand now as we welcome the summit, our faculty and graduates.
Thank you.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the union of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We come together this afternoon in joy and thanksgiving. In joy in the 4-year journey to the class of 2016 with families. And that culmination to be this afternoon in graduation and our commencement exercise. We also come to thanksgiving. Celebration of the body and blood of Christ. It's this call by God to a deeper relationship. So we celebrate that relationship by remembering that baptism. Dear sisters and brothers, let us come to beseech the Lord our God. Bless this water he has created, which we sprinkle on us as the Lord of our baptism. And help us by his grace, we have faith in the Spirit we have received. Almighty Heavenly God, we will let the water of the fountain of life, source of purification, even souls should be cleansed, receive the gift of eternal life. Be pleased, we pray, to bless this water, by which we seek protection on this daily. New living spring of grace within us, and grant that by this water, we be defended from all ills of spirit and life, and so approach you in hearts to be clean and worthy to receive your salvation. Through Christ, our Lord. So as we hear the sacred history of your body and blood, we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. We'll live and reign with God the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Our first scripture reading today will be proclaimed by the valedictorian of the class of 2016, Javier Herrera.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out the bread and wine, and being a priest of God Most High, he blessed Abram with these words. Bless thee, Abram, by God Most High, the creator of heaven and earth. And bless thee, God Most High, who delivered your foes into your hand. Then Abram gave him a tenth of everything. The word of the Lord.
Given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way also the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. The word of the Lord.
And so we call to that. It's a remembrance to them. It's a reminder of who we are. So if we look at the first reading of the book of Genesis, Abram starts a campaign against four kings who came to encroach upon his land and the land of his family. And he succeeded. So he goes to Melchizedek. Melchizedek is a priest, a king of Salem, which some scholars tend to think is what present-day Jerusalem is. It's Jerusalem. So he goes there. This king offers sacrifice and thanksgiving to his God, the creator God, for what Abram just did. So Abram gladly at that point gives over, sacrifices what he had. One tenth of what he had. This is where we get the title from. One tenth of what we have is sacrificed, is given over. That word sacrifice is important. It's important for this reason. Your parents, your family has sacrificed for you to be here today. Now, I don't think many of us really can capture in our hearts what sacrifice means, particularly when we're young. You get it when you have to sacrifice some time in order to study. You have to sacrifice some time when you want to go with your friends and you have to do something else. Or when you have to give up your very livelihood so somebody else can thrive. That's what sacrifice is. And your parents have done that. Your family has done that. They have given up some basic things so you could have this basic thing called good education. Not just anywhere. We have, as I was looking for, care, work, and struggle. That's part of sacrifice. You have sacrificed yourselves to be here today. The problem with the church, it's been a perennial problem, it's been a problem since we started, is that we lose sight of what that sacrifice is. That everything that we have comes from God, and that we have to give back to God. Not because God needs it, or not because God wants it, but because that sacrifice unites us with God. When we give of ourselves, what God has given us, it's because we are sacrificing to become one with God. That's what sacrifice does. That's what Jesus did with his blood. His blood became that blood oath with God that united humanity with God in that man Jesus. So every time we celebrate the Eucharist here, we're remembering that sacrifice where he became one with God, united humanity with God. But we forget that. So we look at the second reading today from Corinthians. Paul is basically chastising that community because they were doing what we're doing today. But they were forgetting one thing. The rich were staying together, and the poor were in the dark someplace else. So the rich had this incredible banquet that they were eating to the point that they were getting drunk. Imagine coming drunk to the Eucharist. They were doing the Eucharist in the context of the meal, and in that very meal, they were so full, they were falling asleep, they were drunk, while the poor had nothing to eat. And Paul sees this. He says, you can't do this. This in and of itself is a testament against you. So he reminds them, let me remind you what we've learned, what I've been taught. That on the night that he died, and that's what the Catholic is reading today, he's reminding them that Jesus sacrificed himself for everybody. My brothers here from me, your days of sacrificing have started, but they continue. You are beginning a different phase of sacrifice. We've been trying to teach you for 4 years that when the poor don't have, that's when you give. When forgiveness is not there, that's when you forgive. When someone is ill and needs healing, that's when you pray the most and you give what you can. When somebody needs you, that's not the time to look someplace else or to shirk it off to somebody else. That's when you step up and you give of yourself until it hurts. That's what your parents did to you. That's what they taught you. That's what they taught us. That's what Paul reminds everybody from the church today. That you can't go on feasting while other people are in family. That's not what we're about. That's exactly the end of the gospel that we heard today. Jesus doesn't just give. He tells them, you give them of what you have. And all they had was five loaves, bread and fish. And that was enough to feed 5,000. Because they gave of what they had. How many times have we seen that in our school? That where you step up, where you have stepped up giving when there was nothing there, or not enough. This is a commencement. You begin this again, but in a different context. So you leave Mount Carmel where you learn these values, where you've learned how to sacrifice. And now you're going to put it to test in a different venture, in a different place, in a different context. Every single one of you, every single one of us. So whether you're empty nesters, and now you have to do things differently, or whether this is the first of many, hopefully. So this is something that we all have to do. We begin differently today. That's what Christ calls us to. He's the one that speaks today. He's the one we follow, always. And for that, we give thanksgiving.
Abel Castillo, the father of Abel Castillo, Jr., Airy Lewis, the mother of Alfred A.J. Lewis, Howard Smith, the father of Ben Smith, and Mr. Kevin Hansen and Mr. Kurt Aronson, our teachers. May they enjoy eternal happiness with God. We pray to the Lord. For the members of the Mount Carmel High School class of 2016, may they be ever close to God, wherever life may take them. We pray to the Lord. For the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Good gracious God, we trust that you hear our prayers. And we ask that you grant them, that they be according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
my sacrifice and yours, to be accepted to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, O Church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, the signs will be seen in mystery, the offerings that you present. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is true, right and just, our duty and our salvation. Lord, Holy Father, mighty eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanded us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh, we have sacrificed for us. We are made strong. And as we drink his blood that is poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, of all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing them with your glory, ask not them, we have plenty.
Listen gracefully to the prayers of this family, whose son here before you.
and your compassion and merciful Father, gather yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, as all who are pleasing to you with their passing from this life, be a kind and innocent to your people. And there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, the Lord who takes away the sins of the world. And bless the Lord's call to suffer. Lord, I'm not worthy of this.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may be the light for all eternity and that share in the divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
One of the great blessings that the class of 2016 has enjoyed during their four-year journey to graduation has been the leadership of Father Tony Mazurkowicz. He was there with you guys for Expedition MC. He was there for the freshman retreat. He was there during so many times of celebration and times of sorrow. So it is great to be here today on this moment of your graduation. Our commencement speaker is Father Tony Mazurkowicz. Trust that who you are and the depth of your voice are enough. As you begin this next chapter of your journey through life, remember the words of a wise Carmelite friend. What someone else thinks about you is none of your business. The second stop is the Memorial Church plan in the fall of 1993. During my freshman year at Yale, I had become close friends with Dennis Parker, classmate from Festus, Missouri. He was on the fencing team, had a black belt in Taekwondo, and was part of the Directed Studies program that took Yale's brightest students. At the end of our freshman year, Dennis and I made plans to move together the following year. We even won the lottery, the option to open God, the name for the best school in our college. A week into our summer break, I received a phone call from Dennis' sister. The night before, Dennis had been working the midnight shift for an environmental company, so I paid for his tuition. And while driving home from work, he fell asleep at the wheel, crossed the knee, and crashed my car in the truck. Just like that, his life was over. Unfortunately, we have all come to know the sad and stark reality of death. 3 years ago this month, we stood shoulder to shoulder as Co-Chief's body was carried from Mount Carmel for the last time. Last week, we stood shoulder to shoulder with people's families in Joliet to celebrate the life and to mourn the death of another beloved teacher, Mr. Hanson. Again, this past October, on the morning that Kevin Zubek took his life, we stood shoulder to shoulder at Cash Toy Center to pray with and to comfort each other. So the reality you and I know, that every parent, grandparent, guardian, and uncle knows, is that life is precious. It's cliche, but it's a fact. You and I never know when the next breath that we take is going to be our last. So let's begin this next chapter in Journey Through Life. One of the favorite quotes from Mr. Hanson: "Don't wait until tomorrow, it's here today." My third stop on campus was from 256 to 252 White College. A few weeks before my college career began, Yale had notified me that I'd be living in a quad with 300 students. Two in each bachelor's suite. Then I'd choose my roommates. So I figured the first guy I saw on campus would be my roommate. When I arrived from 256, the first guy I met was Columbia Jackson in Santa Barbara, California. We had a short conversation. It seemed like a good fit. And then, when he brought in sneakers that were about this tall, as we unpack boxes and negotiate who would get what space in the room, I placed a statue of Mary on my desk and noticed he was taking a picture of Jesus on the wall. Mommy noticed that I was watching, and he asked me if I had any problem with him putting up a picture of a black Jesus. I told him that I absolutely not have a problem with it, and that I loved him. And that was the truth. But had I not walked the halls of 6410 South Dante and experienced the rich diversity of Mount Carmel, I wonder if I could respond to the same manner that Kwame that day. During these past 4 years, you've had the opportunity not only to interact with, but to befriend Carmel men of different socioeconomic backgrounds, races, sexual orientation, abilities, and talents. And you've embraced your differences as a vital component of your brotherhood. As a senior class who traveled on Carmel day after day for 60 zip codes, you've back to exhibition MC. What if I could walk into Mount Carmel for the first time as a freshman? Hopefully, you've moved from making judgments and assumptions to becoming men who strive for justice and for understanding. As you begin this next journey and chapter of your life, continue to cherish and to celebrate God's gift of diversity. Our city, our nation, God's kingdom here on earth, to Him. My final stop on campus is Ray Johnson's house, the home of our athletic office. Couldn't be in my sophomore season, I was fifth of the depth chart at Strong Safety. In game number 88, those who know, it's a tight end, not a defensive back. I remember walking into the coach's office and getting ready to say what I had rehearsed 25 times over the previous week. "Coach, this just isn't working out. I'm ready to play." I just wanted to get in the office, get my piece done, and get out of my life. When I got there, I had to wait. Coach Hopkins was still on the phone. And as the conversation dragged on, I felt like it turned. I kept hearing this tape over and over in the back of my mind. Andre talked about sacrifice. Life is about trouble, working hard, facing adversity. Don't quit. Coach Hopkins finally hung up the phone. I walked into his office and took a deep breath. Instead of quitting, I sat down and watched film of the upcoming opponent. The tape in the back of my mind had done their job. Within a week, our coach had moved a starting strong safety to linebacker. The second stringer had been hurt.
and I did not find the two players in the starting position, which I kept for the next 3 years. Believe me, I was not the most talented player on the field. Far, 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 far. Hard work and perseverance paid off. So as we begin this next chapter in your journey through life, remember how much you have struggled, how hard you have worked. Continue to be resilient in the face of adversity, and make sure that these values are embedded in the foundation that you will rely on as you tackle the future. Remember that the only place where success comes before hard work is ambition. Trust and nurture your voice. Remember that life is precious. Embrace God's gift of diversity. And continue to welcome the struggle. Embrace hard work. I'd like to finish with one more story from Mount Carmel. You may have heard it before, parents, imagine you had as well, told a few times. The first year I served as president, we had hosting Mass again the first one on the street. And shortly before Mass, one of the grandmothers stopped. She grabbed both of my hands and looked straight in the eye. And she said, Father Tony, tell me, you're teaching these guys to fall in love with God. She said, they can be the most successful businessmen, lawyers, athletes, fathers, you name it. If they don't have a relationship with God, it means nothing. Parents and guardians who would not have chosen Mount Carmel, a Christian Catholic Carmelite school, if a relationship with God was not part of your DNA. Thank you for making this commitment and partnering with us in this four-year journey in building God's kingdom. And gentlemen, you've been building God's kingdom for some time. Each school year consists of 180 days. 4 years of high school is 720 days. Some of those days, especially the last few, may have felt like them. But in Mount Carmel, we most likely pray at least 5 times a day for each of those 720 days. Do the math. That's over 3,500 formal opportunities for prayer during these past 4 years. 3,500 opportunities to deepen your relationship with God. I hope that you embrace those opportunities. As you begin this next chapter in your journey of life, keep your hand in the hand of God. Continue to deepen your relationship with Jesus Christ. In the spirit of Pyrrhus, and that each and every day is indeed your opportunity to open the floor. I ask that all of you one more time. Fired up.
Ready to go.
Fired up.
Ready to go.
Fired up.
Ready to go.
Indeed, you are ready to go. Go and make the next chapter of your life the best one. Our Lady of Mount Carmel.
Pray for us.
Thank you.
Daniel, Sammy, and Orr.
Dylan Joseph Arriega. Anwar Kwamian Sante. Zivante Jackson Ash. McKenna Janedu Asonia. Edward Julian Abingham. Michael Christian Walkovich. David Fernando Banda. Hannah Jordan Vera. Christian Joshua Marcus Beal. Maximilian Joseph Lacey. Christian Samuel Horn. Andy Demetrius Jackson Rand. Kevin Patrick Raven. Dontrell Jeremiah Brown. Daniel Michael Bolger. Sebastian Alexander Kane. Christopherson Jeremiah M. Camacho. Abel Castillo Jr. Eduardo Seo. Nicholas Keith Chambers II. Gabriel Antonio Chavez. Corbin Robert Chubin. Nicholas Jack Camini. Maximilian Holby James Uduki. Abel Antonio Peral. Javier Correa. Lee Andrew Davis II. Roberto Del Real Jr. David John Demme. Kyle Joseph Dietz. Timothy Gerald Estacio. Liam Timothy Donahue. John Joseph Rowe. Tyler Joseph Egan. Joseph Guy Hall. Joseph Edward Farrell. William John Beal. Christopher Ignacio Flores, Jr. Zebulon Ducharan Human Walker. Brandon Alexander Del Sosimo. John David Bogina. John Michael Golden. Wallace Evans Good, III. Matthew Elmer Casano. Terrell Levante Greer. Andrew Jacob Garrett. David Joseph Bowen. Joshua Walter Harvey. Roland Emery Hargrove II. Luke James Davis. Adrian Hernandez. Jalen Rashawn Hill. Bryce Jeremiah Hodges. Jeremy Micah Houston. Lavelle Wayne Morgan Houston. Curtis Lee Howard. Henry Lee Hudson III. Alex John Salako. Brendan Joseph Jacobs. Benjamin Mike Garzanda. Devin Terrell Johnson. Ryan Lee Johnson. Brendan Edward Pepper. Joseph Peter Fish. Kenneth Andrew Kobach. Kevin Patrick Farag. Henry Minor Lansing. Gabriel Rashad LeBlanc. Craig Allen Lee Jr. Jake Michael Benton. Alfred Gerald Lewis Jr. Demetrius Rashawn Lewis. John Michael Lewis. Cameron Robert Lopez. Adam Justin Lasoya. Chad Thaddeus Fraser. Gabriel Gerard Newhart. Aiden Patrick Maloney. Clancy Christopher McLeod. Jacob Anthony Marco. Drake Francis McCarrick. Patrick Kelly McDonald. Joseph Terrence McGrath. Daniel Alexander McKay. Matthew Gregory, John O'Connor, Ken, Morgan Victor Mike, Michael Paul Milovitz, Thomas John May, Rashawn Nassim Moore, second, Jose Francisco Moreno, Mark Angelo Mudd, Jr., Ryan Edward Newman, Tristan Gabriel Novak, Neil Lewis Novasov, Ruben Dario Ochoa, Nandi Chigozi Okafonia, Theodore Chikini Okafor, Leo David Ortiz, Patrick Timothy O'Shea, Taylor John Patrick, Matthew Joseph Cleveland Newells, Christian Sean Meade, Thomas William Peters, Jake Stephen Olawacho, Anthony Joseph Montoni, Gavin Arnold Quintero, Michael Patrick Redman, Emmanuel Davis Reed, Michael Patrick Ryder, Austin Michael Ray, Matthew John Reyes Nato, Jacob Robert Rose, Jordan Christopher Richardson, Anthony Tyrone Reese Jr., Kevin Rivera, Alexander Israel Patron, Matthew Christian Robinson, Galvin Tyree Robinson III, Anthony Paul Russell, Dominic David O'Brien, Joseph Sadie, Avery Jacob Sappho, John Patrick Scanlon, Matthew Allen Schott, Dallas John Schill, Kyle Peter Singleton, Nicholas John Slum, Benjamin Francis Smith, Connor Joseph Spear, Masai Jason Spencer, Matthew Jason Augusta, Azera Kareem Barbosa, Anthony William Thompson, Kyrene Stephen Thurman, Scott Michael Robin, Jacob Wesley D. Parker, Bartholomew Kessler Parker, Miguel Angel Green, Jose Angel Covial Jr., Michael Anthony Vidrid, Jordan Nicholas Williams, Stephen Patrick Orta, Justin Fortuna Kalani Woodard, Drew Allen Worker, Cameron Joseph Young, Vincent Wesley Garak, Ryan Conn Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the last of the night. The Buckingham Building Presidential Award is presented to the President of the Student Council in recognition of his leadership of our student body in that role. Father Dillon Presidential Award goes to Benjamin Jarzanga. The Father Peter Hines O'Connor Service Award is named in honor of Carmelite priest who dedicated his life to teaching Catholics about the relationship between faith and service to the poor. It's awarded to a senior or seniors who have set an overview example of Christian service during their years at Mount Carmel. And this year we're happy to recognize three seniors with the Father Peter Hines Award. They are Maximilian Luisi, Chapo Lavacha, and Don Chorman.
Thank you.
his son from North Carolina. So we invite the Greer family to come forward in time to receive a plaque for that family.
Go in peace, love the Lord and one another. Thanks be to God.